First, I will show you how to download photos from Google Photos individually or as a group. Second, I will show you how to download all your photos from Google Photos at once. Third, I will show you how and where to download your photos from Google Photos and organize them at the same time, giving you the ability to upload, attach, and drag the photos, view them from any device, and prevent you from losing them if your hard drive crashes. So first, let's go into Google Photos. And if you wanted to download one, you'd click on the blue checkmark on the top left. If you wanted to download a couple, you'd click on the checkmark in the top left of the photo. If you wanted to download a bunch of them, you'd go to the last photo you wanted to download, hold down the shift key, and click on that, and then go to the top right where the three dots are and click on download, and it would download all of those photos. Now, to download all of the photos at once, you want to go to the address bar and type in takeout.google.com and then scroll down a little bit, and you see all the Google products are all checked here. What you want to do is click deselect all and then move down to Google Photos. Click on that. And on multiple formats, if you click on that, what that's just telling you is that the format that the Google photo or video was recorded in is going to be the same format it will be downloaded in. Let's click OK. And next to that, all photo albums included, click on that. And you see all the photo albums that I created here in Google Photos. And also, it takes all the photos by year and subcategorizes them. So you can choose everything by leaving everything selected, or you can select individual photo albums or individual years and download that. I'm going to click deselect all, and I'm only going to download one album, and I'm going to click on OK and then move down to the bottom. Click next step. And here, the delivery method, you have choices of downloading it via a link via email, or to Drive, Dropbox, OneDrive, or to Box. I'm going to leave it as a download link via email. Frequency, you can download it once, export it once, or export it every 2 months for a year. And I'm going to leave that at export it once. File size is either .zip or .tgz. I am not familiar with .tgz, so I'd recommend leaving it as .zip. And then the last choice is how big are the file sizes. And this is going to depend upon how good of an internet connection you have. So here we can see anywhere from 1 gigabyte all the way up to 50 gigabytes. I'll leave that at 2 gigabytes. And you're going to click Create Export. And now it is emailing you the download. So you can go to your Gmail account and you see it right here. Or you can click the download button right here and it will download it. And if we double click on Show in Folder and you see Takeout, click on Takeout. Click on Takeout again, and you see the Google Photos. Click on that. And these are all the photos. And some of these other files here are just meta files, not necessary for you to worry about. You can actually delete those. But those are the photos that have just been downloaded. Now, my favorite way to manage photos from Google Photos is to use Google Drive. And the benefit of using Google Drive is it's also a cloud service. So any photos in Google Drive, you don't have to worry about a hard drive crashing, first of all. And second, any photos in Google Drive, you have the ability to upload, attach, or drag those photos where you want, where you don't have that ability in Google Photos. So I already have a Google Photos folder already created, because in the past, Google Photos used to sync with Google Drive, and unfortunately they stopped that a few years ago. So you can see here that the folders are all categorized by year. And if I click on the last year, 2019, you can see they are subcategorized by month. So what I'm going to do is go into the 2019 folder, and I'm going to click on that, and I'm going to create a new folder and call it 10 for the 10th month of the year, October. And you see that right there. And then I'm going to go back to Google Photos, and to find the specific year and month of photos that you want to download in Google Photos, just take your cursor and move it off to the right. You'll see a timeline pop up with the a bar and an up and down arrow. Just click down, and then you can pull that bar down to the exact year and month that you want. And I am going to select all the photos from October. And so you see these photos have already been selected here from my previous work that I just did. So then I'm going to move up and find the last batch of photos from October. And before I click that, I'm going to click on the shift key, and then I'm going to click that check mark. And all of the photos from October have now been selected. I'm going to go up to the top right where the three dots are, click on that. I'm going to click on download. That's going to download all those photos. And then we're going to move them over to the Google Drive folder I just created. So click on show in folder. Okay. And you can see the photos are right here. I'm going to open up Google Drive. I have a Chromebook, and so I'm able to do this. You might have to just copy the folders, the photos. So I'm going to open up right to that folder. That's where I want all those photos to go. But I'm going to double click that file. So these are all my photos. And I'm going to click the top one and then move all the way down to the bottom and click the last one. So they're all selected. And then I'm going to click on one and drag them all to that folder number 10. So that's going to put all those photos into the Google Drive folder of 2019, the 10th month. And just to check on that, we'll go to, you can see it's syncing now. 5 seconds remaining, or 5 minutes, 2 minutes remaining, a minute remaining. So those should all be synced up to that Google Drive folder. So we're going to go back into Google Drive. I'm going to look at that folder number 10. You can see the photos are showing up right there. And again, I think this is a nice way of organizing your photos so you have them all by month and by year and then by month. And so you're able to do whatever you want with them. I hope this video has been helpful. If it has, please leave me give me a thumbs up. Subscribe for more helpful videos such as this. Thank you very much. Bye now.